In the beginning was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word.
And the Word was with God.
The Word was with God.
And the Word was God.
The Word was
God. He was with God in the beginning.
John 1:1-2.
In the beginning was the Word, was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word, was the Word.
And the Word was with God.
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 And the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. And the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. John 1:1-2.
John 1:1-2.
In the beginning was the Word, was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word, was the Word.
And the Word was with God.
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 And the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. And the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. And the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. And the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning.
John 1:1-2.
Hi, I hope you've been enjoying all this snow. We don't get snow like this very often where we live, and so we usually have to wait for something like this to happen. Today's Bible story is about two people that were waiting for something that had never happened before. Part of this story will make more sense if we remember our big picture question and answer. Is Jesus God or human? As the Son of God, Jesus is both fully God and fully human. This means that Jesus completely understands what it feels like to be human. He can relate to our fears, our frustrations, the ways we are tempted, and our pain and sadness. Jesus also has all the power and glory of God. He is God the Son and was able to bear on the cross the full weight of God's anger toward our sin. In today's story, we will learn that Simeon and Anna worshiped Jesus because they knew he was not an ordinary baby. Jesus was God, the Savior. Today's Bible story comes from Luke chapter 2. The Bible is the most important book there is because the Bible is God's Word. God's Word is true. Luke is one of the Gospels. The Gospels tell about Jesus' birth, life, death, and resurrection. Remember, all the stories in the Bible fit together to tell an even bigger story. The story about how God rescues sinners through his son, Jesus. Jesus had an earthly family, just like we do. Jesus' family line proved he is the Messiah. Jesus is the fulfillment of all God's promises to Adam, Abraham, David, and more. Then we learned that God sent a messenger to go before Jesus, just as he promised he would. John was born to prepare the way for Jesus. And then last week, we reviewed the story of the moment that God's people had been waiting for. Jesus was born to be God's promised Savior. This week, we'll learn about the time that Jesus was dedicated in the temple. After Jesus was born, Mary and Joseph obeyed God's words and brought baby Jesus to the temple to give a gift to God. They brought two birds to give to God. A man named Simeon had been waiting to see the special king who God had promised to send. God told Simeon that he would see God's special king before he died. When Mary and Joseph brought baby Jesus to the temple, Simeon held baby Jesus and praised God. Mary and Joseph were surprised. Then a woman named Anna also praised God and told people in the temple that Jesus was the special king whom God had promised to send. After that, Mary and Joseph took baby Jesus home. Jesus grew up and God was with him. Let's find out more about our story this week by watching our video together.
Mary and Joseph's baby, God's own son, was a few days old when Mary and Joseph named him Jesus, just like the angel had told them to do. When Jesus was a few weeks old, Mary and Joseph took Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem. Mary and Joseph wanted to obey God and his law. The law that God gave Moses said, when a woman's first son is born, his parents must dedicate him to the Lord. The law also said that the child's parents should give a sacrifice. At the temple, Mary and Joseph presented Jesus to the Lord and offered two birds as a sacrifice. Another man was at the temple. His name was Simeon. Simeon loved God, and he trusted in God's promise to send a Messiah to save people from sin. God's Spirit was with Simeon, and God had told Simeon that he would not die until he saw the one who would rescue people from their sin. That day, God's Spirit had led Simeon to the temple. Simeon saw Jesus and picked him up in his arms. God's Spirit showed Simeon that Jesus was the promised Messiah. Simeon was so happy. He praised God and said, Lord, you can let me die now. You kept your promise, and I have seen the one who will save people from sin. Simeon said that Jesus would save God's people, the Israelites, and Jesus would also save people from other nations. Mary and Joseph were amazed at what Simeon said. Simeon blessed Mary and Joseph. He told Mary that being Jesus' mother would be a very good thing, but it would also be very hard. Some people would love Jesus, but others would hate him. Things were going to happen that would make Mary very sad. A woman named Anna was at the temple too. Anna's husband had died, and Anna was very old. She stayed at the temple and worshiped God all the time. Anna came up to Simeon, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, and she began to thank God. Anna talked about Jesus to people who were waiting for God to keep his promise to send a Savior. She told them the good news. The Savior was here. Mary and Joseph finished dedicating Jesus and making sacrifices to God. They obeyed God's law. Then they went back home to Nazareth. Jesus grew up and was strong and healthy. He was wise, and God was happy with him. Throughout the Old Testament, God promised the arrival of a king who would redeem people. When Jesus arrived, Simeon and Anna knew he was the promised Messiah. Today, we have faith that Jesus is God's Son. We can trust Jesus for our salvation, and like Simeon and Anna, we should share the good news.
One thing I want to point out is that Mary and Joseph obeyed the laws that God had given to his people about how to present a baby at the temple. Jesus' parents knew that Jesus was God's son, and they were committed to raising him the way God said to raise children. Jesus' whole life perfectly fulfilled God's laws, even when he was just a baby. It's also interesting to see that Simeon found Jesus in the temple because God's Spirit led him there. God told Simeon that he would live to see the day that the Messiah arrived, and God is always faithful to keep his promises. Simeon praised God and declared the truth about Jesus, that he would save people from sin. The nation of Israel had been waiting for years and years to see the Messiah, but not everyone lived to see him. What a special feeling that must have been for Simeon. After Anna met Jesus, she began to tell those around her about Jesus too. She understood God's faithfulness. The people had been waiting for salvation, and the one who would provide it had finally come. Simeon and Anna worshiped Jesus as the Messiah. Simeon and Anna did not just understand who Jesus is, they told others about him and what he would do. Throughout the Old Testament, God promised the arrival of a king who would redeem people. When Jesus arrived, Simeon and Anna knew he was the promised Messiah. Today, we have faith that Jesus is God's Son. We can trust Jesus for our salvation, and like Simeon and Anna, we should share the good news. Our key passage is John 1, 1 through 2. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. When the verse says Word, it means Jesus. The Word, Jesus, was God. They are the same. Simeon and Anna recognized that Jesus was not just an ordinary baby. They knew he was the Savior who had come to save people from sin. John began his book with this key passage. His writing, inspired by God, helps us understand Jesus' nature. Jesus has always existed. Even though his life as a human had a starting point, God the Son has no beginning and no end. At the start of creation, Jesus was already there. He was with God the Father and God the Spirit then, and he is eternally God the Son. After I pray, we will listen to our Bible story song with emotions. Lord, you are good and your mercy goes on forever. We praise you alone because of who you are and what you have done. Help us trust you daily. Make our obedience an overflow of our love for you. Thank you for sending Jesus the Messiah to save us. Amen.